Tonight on Sydney Soapbox, we're asking, what's the worst Christmas present you have received? Let us know your views on Facebook, Twitter or email.
In a moment, we'll hear what writer Jane Caro has to say, but first, here's the view from Chatswood.
The ones I've given people before and then they rewrap it and give it back to me, those are the worst ones.
A plate, like a cheese platter, and it's still in its box.
Some nappies.
Some nappies. Do you have any babies?
No.
Socks. Socks are dodgy.
Yeah, my aunt sends me socks every year.
A knife sharpener by my husband.
Do you use that?
No, I don't. He uses it, but I've never used it.
It's a chewed pen.
A chewed pen.
That's pretty much the worst present I've ever gotten.
I was given once, like, the underwear that has all the days on the week on it.
A terry toweling shower cap.
And what did you do with that?
I re-gifted it.
Everyone has a story to tell. So let's find out Jane Caro's story. Jane, what's the worst Christmas present you've ever received?
It was one of those things where they give a goat to a village and then they say to you, now don't you feel great? I've given a goat to a village in your name. And somehow it managed to make me feel guilty and really resentful all at the same time. You know, if I want to give a goat to a village, I'll decide to give a goat to a village. I wanted a present and I'd give a goat to a village if I felt like it. I really hated it, and I hated that I couldn't say, no, don't do that on my behalf. Let me be charitable if I want to be. So that was that one. But there are so many bad ones. Talcum powder, soaps, socks, as someone mentioned, is really bad. Underwear of any kind, I think, is pretty bad unless you've got a very, very close relationship. Music that you sort of look at the CD gift that you've been given and you think, who do they think I am? I think I got Pat Boone from my father-in-law once and he thought he was being groovy and I was devastated. So yes, anything that could be seen as insulting is always a bad idea. But no, I can't get over the goat for the village and the whole charitable thing. If I'm going to be charitable, I want to feel good about it, not kind of like you've made me feel like I'm not charitable enough and yet it's Christmas. Yuck.
Well, Jane, what's your advice if you're on the spot, if you have to react, if the person's there or you see them very soon afterwards? What do you do?
It's so difficult because I'm not, as you can see, terribly po-faced. And so the reaction when I opened the card and it said, I've given a goat to a village on your behalf, was to shake it and see if there was a check in it, I think. And I wouldn't advise that. It didn't go down well. I guess you've just got to be really polite and remember your manners and say, oh, thank you so much. I so hope the people in the village really appreciate the goat. Does it have a name? Anything like that will do. And then if it's a goat to a village, you don't have a problem because the villagers have the problem. If they didn't want the goat, you don't. But if it's the talcum powder, the soap, the whatever, the hankies, re-gifting it is often a good idea, or perhaps give it to Vinnie's.
Jane Caro, thank you.
Pleasure.